lecturer in my fellow classmates. I'm Vincent.
I'm Mohamed Yasir.
I'm Kenda.
I'm Mirichao.
For this assignment, we have chosen LaundryMate as our company to do our analysis. Yes, this is the requirement of our subject, marketing for small business enterprise. Small business. Then I will pass it to Yasir to talk about the introduction of our chosen company.
So today I will talk about the company background of LaundryBar. LaundryBar is a trademark service laundry concept under City Point Sendirian Mahat, and it directed by Mr. Paulner, which is the CEO of the LaundryBar company, and Ms. Sandra Chua is the executive director of the LaundryBar company. And LaundryBar company deliver quality laundry experience through self-service laundry with convenient, eco-friendly, hygienic yet affordable with 60 minutes. And LaundryBar has 365 outlets operating within Malaysia, which is in Sabah. There are two outlets which located at the Kingfisher and Nana, which is Taipan. And for the vision and mission of the company, the vision of the company, LaundryBar Inclusion, being the largest self-service laundromat provider in Southeast Asia, that incorporates cutting-edge technology into their service to provide the best laundry experience possible to their customers, whilst protecting the environment. For their mission is to committed to deliver superior quality laundry management experience to their customer through convenient, eco-friendly, hygienic yet affordable within 60 affordable laundry management solutions within 60 minutes. For the next, I'll pass to Vincent to talk about the pestle analysis.
Good morning, I'm Vincent. So for the next part of this presentation, I'll be talking about pestle analysis. So pestle analysis is a tool or framework that is used by different organizations to study the factors that will impact the business. So the first factor is political factor. So a political factor, our country has recently just announced the introduction of the new taxation system, which is the SST, sales and service tax, and it replaced the one we had before, which is goods and service tax, GST. So it was found the cost of the material might be higher compared to the prices that is with GST. So the second factor is economical factors. In economical factors, the growth, the GDP growth of our country has dropped from 5.4 in the first quarter of the 2018 to 4.5% in the second quarter of the 2018. This indicates that the customer spending has reduced, and while the customer spending reduced, the business of LaundryBar will also be affected as there are less people spending money. So the third factor is social factor. From last year, there's a new type of laundry shop opening, which it is Muslim only. So only Muslim are allowed to use their washer and toilet. So this type of laundry shop is new in Malaysia, and the demand might increase for this type of laundry shop, and it will become a new market opportunity for LaundryBar to open new shops. So the next factor is technological factor. In technological factor, there's a new type of washer and dryer is the two-in-one washer and dryer unit is introduced to the market, and laundry bar can use this to save more space and cost in their company. And the final factor is environmental factor. So people nowadays, they want everything is healthy and as everything must be green. So chemical that is used in the soap of the laundry shop are very hazardous, toxic and dangerous to human beings. Although laundry bar is focused on eco-friendly and healthy, and but some research actually shown that the chemical that is labeled safe to use, it might also be dangerous. So for the next part, we'll pass to Angela.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Angela. I am present about the sports analysis and target market. The strength is the laundry bar is the first in Malaysia to provide free in-house formulated laundry chemical to laundry users. The only American brand washing machine that provides 7 years warranty across SEA, that is Southeast Asia, and it is formulated laundry detergent is halal and it is 24-hour care life for the service maintenance. For the washing for dryer is cannot function or got problem. And the weakness is the straw is limited space. It is limited space for the customer to wetting their cost and lower brand awareness and unclean price list. The opportunity is the small number of self-service laundry store in Malaysia, a constant and consistent market demand because everyone has dirty clothes to wash. The trend is daily habit of washing clothes by hand at home. And then the business model is easy to copy because there are many competitors in the suburbs, for example, the clean pool laundry in Asia City. And then the target market is they choose for students, small family, and young professionals. The student is land of spend in dormitory, and small family is land of spend and time the spend to cost their to washing their clothes, and the young person is like to travel, explore and outgoing, and demographic segment is they choose the male and females and 20 to 50 age group and. There are
lower income and middle income, and I pass to you.
Thank you, Angela, for highlighting the SWOT analysis and also the target market.
My name is Kenneth. I'm going to talk about the marketing focus. For our product strategy, the laundry bar has two main products, which is commercial washer and also commercial dryer. The commercial washer has energy saving option and with integrated technology, which can reduce the consumption of the water and also the time of washing. So, and for the dryer, it with the perfectly balanced heat, cylinder design and also the airflow. So the laundry bar dryers can dry the cloth more faster. For both washer and dryers, it has heavy duty characteristic which can last more longer than usual. I'm talking about the branding. The branding for Don Riva is very good. It has a good branding image, which Don Riva has is convenient, is hygienic, is with affordable price. So next, so like just how I said, everyone is focused and cares about the price. So we provide with Don Riva offer excellent product and services with lower price. Don Riva also using penetration pricing, we set the cost at low. Our price range is from 4.50 ringgit to 14 ringgit. Now I will pass it to Vincent.
So the promo for the promotional strategy of Longiva, they are using a lot of social media marketing, as they have their own Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram pages that will constantly update their customer with their latest news or anything that is happening in the company. And they are also using SMS marketing. They will distribute their own laundry bags to people, and they also advertise their shop on billboards. And the next way is trade exhibition. This is to increase the brand awareness, so let more people know about their brand. So the fourth way is they're using word of mouth. People like they're passing, they are telling their friends and relatives about this. Longiva, they provide affordable price, so they will attract more customers to go to Longiva. For the distribution strategy part, since the Longiva start operating in Malaysia, today there is more than 365 outlets available throughout Malaysia, but most of it is in West Malaysia. There's only 2 outlets in Sabah. So Longiva is using their washing machine to provide service to the customer, which is considered as a type of direct sales. And for the next part of the recommendation, I'll pass it to Kevin.
Thank you, sir, for this part. So there's some recommendation for the marketing mix. For the Longiva, the first, we are strongly suggest that Longiva should open more store which laundry, open the store which the laundry and the cafeteria come together, and maybe a small snack corner might help to gain the revenue for the business, because during for the laundry user, because they have to wait for 1 hour for their clothes to be finished. In that 1 hour, they might not have anything to do. So like this, they might find any new thing to do during the process of their clothes. And the second is promotion. We strongly suggest that Longiva should have a membership system for the customer who frequently come to use the laundry, because if they keep on coming to use the services the Longiva provide and they do not get any reward from the services, they might get bored or they might look for another shop or company to use their services. The third is price. We strongly suggest the Longiva should start on using the top even pricing strategy, because it's a psychological technique which, even though there's a small amount between 3 ringgit and 2 ringgit 99 cent, And still, 2 ringgit 99 cents is much, is low, much more cheaper than the 3 ringgit because it's a psychological way of doing business. And the last partner place is for the place, Riva should open more branches near to university area, like hotel and homestead and hospital, and they can also go for international. Because we should have suggested that Riva should open, not open up, they should cooperate with the hospital because there's a lot of victim and the guardian of the victim, the patient, they don't have to go so far to like wash their clothes or they have to go back to their house to take the clothes. With the services Pandipa can provide, they can just wash the, take the clothes and go to the laundry and use the services. It can also reduce the time and save costs. So this is our references list, and that's all from us. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Any question?
Okay, I do have one question here. Why do you say that the distribution strategy is, laundry bus distribution strategy is considered as a direct sales?
They just put the machine there and the customer, they, if let's say they want to use the services, they have to come by their own to use the services. Because everyone doesn't provide any helper or the worker to help the customer to you, to like wash the clothes for them. Because not everyone is like self-service laundry. We have to do our laundry by ourselves.
Another question would be, what do you think is the success, the extent of success of having loyalty program in parts of your recommendation for promotion for the club?
So, by having a loyal customer loyalty program, it can attract more customer, and also build a loyal customer base. Because by having this program, customers that come regularly will be able to collect points and will give and will get reward in return. So this is a very great ways to have build up a large customer base.
Would you say this is also part of the relationship marketing strategy?
Yes, I think
yes.
So.
Okay, good. Why is odd even pricing so important in your opinion? For the river?
Even pricing strategy is very important is because if we set the price like 2 ringgit and 90 cent compared to 3 ringgit, normally people will choose the 2 ringgit and 90 cent even there is only one 10 cent or we can make it like 2 ringgit 99 cent instead of just 3 ringgit. So there is actually is no different, but for customer it is a psychological strategy. So customer normally will pick the 2 ringgit and 99 cents.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay, last question. In your pastel slide, the fourth slide in the beginning, and the economic factor. economic factor, you have mentioned that the GDP has slowed down from 5.4% to 4.5% in the second quarter of this year. So what is the impact towards consumer spending, especially towards people who go for self-service laundry, in your opinion, with these changes in the economy?
Okay, so so we know that the consumer spending is one of part of the GDP. So if GDP drop, it also indicates that the spending of the customer is drop. When the spending of the customer is drop, the customer will try to wash their clothes at house instead of their going, because actually going out to wash a cloth is also not too, is also quite expensive for a small families. So maybe they will try to wash the cloth at their home, even if it's quite complicated for them, maybe the time. So they will choose it.
How would you, in terms of pricing, then how would you tackle this problem?
Just now we have mentioned, so the pricing strategy that we use is penetration pricing. So the penetration, the laundry mart is using the penetration pricing. We set the price at initial. So when the price is low, then it can target more customer, and also increase the brand awareness and also the market share in Malaysia, yes. Especially in Sabah.
Thank you very much for the question and answer session. It has been a very good presentation. Okay, thank you very much.